I'm here now with Kristen Degan, who, along with Chris Armour, were the teachers at Williamston High School who taught the Interactions Project curriculum in their ninth grade physical science classes this year. And furthermore, they were both gracious enough to invite me in to co-teach the classes with them. So we're trying to get a sense of what NGSS will mean to teachers as this gets rolled out in classrooms. Mm-hmm. So from your perspective, Kristen, how is it different for you this year teaching a curriculum that's aligned to the next generation science standards?
There were a number of different changes. Number one, I would say, is my role of a teacher shifted significantly from a kind of holder of knowledge or the giver of knowledge to more of a developer of knowledge and understanding. Using different questioning techniques, we were able to kind of probe the students' understanding, their prior knowledge, and then given different situations or different lab experiences, activities, experiments, we were able to then gain evidence and have students draw upon their conclusions to then create their own understanding. So for me, I saw it being much more personal for students than kind of arbitrary memorization of definitions. A few other areas where it was significantly different was holding myself back from telling students if they were correct or incorrect in their initial ideas or in patterns that they observed from their observations. It was hard for me to kind of shift from telling students, yes, you're right, or no, you're wrong, to, I understand what you're saying. Okay, now let's go a little bit further. So that was a significant change for me. Also, the pacing of the learning with the curriculum was a little bit different. It was slower than I'm typically used to, going through lessons and activities in the classroom. But the flip side to that, and what I see as a benefit, is that the student understanding is much greater. Their depth of knowledge has increased, and their retention of that knowledge throughout the semester is greatly improved from what I've seen in past years. Something that I really also liked about the curriculum and teaching towards the NGSS standards is that we're really out for performance-based objectives. This curriculum that we used was wonderful in that every unit, every activity, every investigation had a driving question. So we were always seeking knowledge to answer a question, not just, hey kids, today we're going to learn about atoms and boom, deliver that information. It was always striving to find evidence, to test theories, to gain more understanding so that we could then answer those driving questions. What was also different was that the curriculum itself was very cyclic in nature, in that we kept coming back to the same ideas over and over again, but applying them in different situations. And I see that as a huge benefit as students move forward in their science career at the high school level, is that they're going to be able to use this information in their depth of understanding and apply it to other situations, whether it's in biology or chemistry or physics or any other science class that they happen to take. In the classroom, discussion was much more of a focus than I've used in the past. There was a lot of group work and class-wide discussions where we as a class gathered up our data and were able to collaboratively come to some conclusions based on that evidence. So using class-wide data, we were then able to formulate specific solutions to questions that we had, or come to a group understanding of a particular topic.
So it sounds like you see your own role is shifting from like knowing the answers mm-hmm. to guiding a lot more questions. There's also a lot more interactions with the students. Mm-hmm. And even though it's at a slower pace, the students are getting a deeper understanding by keeping Correct. To come back to the same ideas mm-hmm. over and over. So you've talked a little bit about how it impacted like the students' understanding of the ideas mm-hmm. that they're developing. What other differences do you think that this had for the students in the classroom? How was it different for the kids?
I think at first, one of the main differences or challenges I saw from the student perspective is that they, at the beginning, they became easily frustrated with this idea of not knowing whether what they were saying or their idea was correct or incorrect. They're very used to that in their science class. This is the right answer, this is the wrong answer. by not giving them that immediate conclusive feedback, it forced them to continue their thinking and not just stop with the memorization of a term, for example. They had to keep thinking through and questioning an observation they made or a comment another student had and trying to think, based on what we've studied so far, can I prove or disprove this idea? And what evidence can I use to support that claim? So that was a struggle for students at first, but the more and more we practiced that and they saw that I wasn't going to give them, yes, you're right, no, you're wrong, a conclusive answer, then I think they started to really enjoy that, their ability to think for themselves and to share their thoughts and ideas without being judged. And developing that understanding and those concepts on their own, it made it much more meaningful to the students, which then in turn, I believe, is going to help them retain that knowledge much, much longer.
So it sounds like at first it's kind of scary and difficult for the kids because they're not getting that immediate feedback of yes or no, but then they eventually figured out that they could figure it out themselves using the evidence that they're gathering. I'm curious about how that played out for like kids who typically struggle in science versus kids that typically excel in science. Was it harder for one or the other or different for the other groups?
I think it was different, but I don't believe it was harder. I think it was actually much more comfortable for many of the students. Once they got used to the way that things were going to play out in class, I think it really did benefit both my lower level students who typically struggled in science and my more kind of academically, you know, strong students as far as science is concerned. The lower level students were able to participate and contribute without that fear of whether their answer was right or wrong. They were able to participate in class discussions based on what they thought, what they observed, what they think could have been a reason behind a particular observation or a result that they encountered in an activity. And then also on the flip side, the students that typically find science a little bit easier or those students that have maybe some more advanced science knowledge, they were able to bring some of that to the table. They were able to share some of their own experiences or a trip that they had taken somewhere to a science museum or an experiment that they had done on their own at home and then share that out with the class. So I really think it benefited all students.
So it sounds like even though it may have been at first scary and difficult to not know if what I'm saying is right or wrong, once that classroom developed, that classroom culture developed where you don't have to be worried about being judged for your answer, then all students were really able to participate in those discussions.
Correct. It went from more of an individual learning experience to a collaborative learning experience. So everyone, it was essential that we all work together to reach that goal. It was rare that someone was left behind in the process. It's like we tackled a problem together, we moved forward, we questioned, we experimented, we gathered evidence, we observed data, we made conclusions, looked for patterns, and then as a whole, we were able to come up with an answer to kind of a guiding question.
So how about just in general, what do you see as like the big changes teachers are going to have to face as these next generation science standards are rolled out?
What's different for teachers that I see when rolling out the next generation science standards is that the emphasis is not so much on the body of knowledge. It's less memorization and more understanding of the processes of what scientists go through. So teachers are going to have to learn how to teach differently. I think professional development for teachers is absolutely essential because it's very different than the way many science teachers were taught to teach science. So there is going to be some learning and a learning curve for teachers as well in order to teach to these standards because the depth of knowledge is much greater compared to the breadth of topics. Many topics that I have, say, taught in the past would not be typically or would not be now included within these standards, but the depth at which we go into the understanding and the underlying concepts of these topics is much, much, much greater, which I believe is going to strengthen student understanding and also retention as they move forward and apply that information in new situations.
Well, thanks again, Kristen, for inviting me in to co-teach with your classrooms. I had a great
time. Thank you. We had a great time, too, and learned a lot.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Myself and students included.
So these next generation science standards really represent a significant shift in what teaching and learning in the science classroom looks like, where students are making sense of phenomenon by blending disciplinary core ideas, cross-cutting concepts, and scientific and engineering practices in order to really explain observations, not just memorize ideas. This is a significant shift in what it looks like in the science classroom. So we're hoping that these video clips will give you kind of an insight of how this actually plays out in a classroom. In the rest of the clips, you'll see footage from the actual classrooms where we were co-teaching students as they worked through this curriculum from the Interactions Project, an NGSS-aligned curriculum.